You're listening to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast with your host, T. Penzel. Enjoy. Enjoy.
3, 2, 1, and we roll. What's going on? It's your boy, T. Penzel. Welcome back to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast. I am your host. I'm here today with some of the cast and crew from the Buried web series. If you have not seen the web series, it's on my channel. Check it out. 6 phenomenal episodes we've been dropping every week since like Thanksgiving. And we dropped the finale on Christmas. Happy holidays to everybody out there. And make sure y'all tell a friend, tell another friend about the podcast. And when you get a chance, leave a dope review and a comment. We're streaming on everywhere. Spotify, Apple Podcasts, all of that great stuff. Say hello, guys.
Hi.
What's going on?
Yo, I didn't you already know.
Podcast we were doing.
Yeah.
We were doing a very like thing. I didn't know this was
weird. Yeah, you're here.
This is the first time I'm on Real Talk Pill Talk. Oh,
wow.
Snap.
You done made it to the big leagues, man.
For real.
Moving on up, we're doing a podcast.
Who knew?
Greetings. Hey.
Hey, everybody. I made it.
Yeah. So introduce yourself, Nadia, and your character, like your character name. You can give him that.
Well, like you said, my name is Nadia Adelaide. My character name is Lauren. And I think, it's y'all turn.
What's going on, people? My name is Ty. Go by Ty Crane, and my character's name is Patrick.
All right.
Yo, my name is Rennell. Everybody calls me Nels. My character is Alan.
Good old Alan.
We love Alan.
Yeah. I don't like Alan's raggedy cut.
And Ty, you came on strong last two episodes.
Yeah, I was on about 35 seconds of episode 6 and about 3 seconds of episode 5.
Wow. Yes. But season 2.
Don't blink, you'll miss me.
But season 2, though.
Season 2.
Season 2.
I'm going to be in that thing. Pause.
All up and through there. Whoa.
Season 2, though.
They both said it. That's crazy.
Yeah.
We're going to be in that thing. Pause. All right. What we got?
All right. So,
well, speaking to the mic, though, get up on now. Pause.
Whoa. Okay. Yeah.
Get all up right. On. Please.
Am I in the wrong show? Play.
All right. So, boom. All right. We're here. All right. So, the first question we got is, how is your character like you? Or, wait, my bad.
Take
your
time.
How is this character like you? ? Different? ?
All right. So, how is this character like you, and how is this character different from you? No, I copied and pasted. So these questions came from the communities tab on my YouTube. So these are all you guys' questions. I'll have your names popping up on the screen as well if you're watching the visuals.
Essentially, what he's saying is shout out to your grammatical errors.
Yeah, it wasn't
all
good.
Yeah, well, it is tough reading some of that stuff. It is tough. Because people like type, you know, they like type it out how they text. So you're like,
right, you got to
sound a little special.
And they say R for hour.
Yeah.
FR for real.
THR.
Yeah.
It's weird. Anyway, all right. So on the question, I feel like everyone wants to hear from Alan.
Oh, yeah. My God.
Yeah.
So it's only right we start there. How is your character different, but do you see your character?
Similarities and differences?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Well, we'll start with the similarities because it's not too many, which I think I think that was the most enjoyable part was like, man, it was interesting to kind of tap into that kind of personality. I like how passionate he is. I like the fact that he cares. I think that I could tap into that. His delivery with how he cares is a little wrong, but, you know, he means well. As far as differences, I mean, it's the delivery, just the way he handles himself, the way he did certain things. He was super abrasive. I felt like a lot of times he didn't really read the room. Especially watching it back, I was like, oh, that's really cringe. Especially the scene where he just kind of just walks in the house. He's like, hey, you. And he just gets to talking. I was like, all right, I would never do that. Like, that's a door. There's a doorbell. So ring that. You know what I mean? So.
About those light bulbs.
I'm like, damn, okay, you walked in there just to change some light bulbs, bro. Yeah,
they were killing you in the comments. Oh, they're so corny. I hate people like that.
Somebody said that Alan is the where's my hug type.
Yeah.
And that one hurt.
But already have his hands out.
Oh, that would hurt me. Grit.
Without me?
Without me.
About to get in the shower. Without me? It's Alan. Without me?
Stop. Yeah. All right, let's move on to the next character. Oh, that would hurt.
You said just go to the next.
Just move on to the next. All
right, go ahead, Nadia.
No, I thought it was going to go in line. All right. Am I like Lauren? There's a lot of similarities between Lauren and I feel. I think she's very passionate. She's a hopeless romantic, I think, in a lot of ways. She is very driven as far as career, which we have in common. And then as far as like love life, I think she knows what she wants, but she's also like teetering on this, like, you know, she doesn't want to repeat her old past mistakes, but she's also not afraid to jump into new things and test waters as far as just like making herself happy. So in that way, I think we are a lot alike, but I don't know. The hopeless romantic thing, I don't think we're too much alike.
So you don't see yourself being like a hopeless romantic?
No, because I'm gonna do my research. Like all the stuff that Alan found out, I'm gonna find out before. Yeah, I would have told him, like, no, yeah, this man Alan is no
I did
good.
My due diligence.
He tried it. Like, I need you to tell me these
things. I knew already.
Calm your nerves.
But like she's very much so, I'm looking at the good traits and how he treats me. And yeah, I'm looking at that too. But I'm also looking at your receipts and your history and, you know, FBI agent.
You got to check the Carfax.
Y'all that.
I feel like your character in the beginning, even with like the eye gaze, like came off of like a little thirsty. Like you've been, like you've been needing like some attention.
I think
like,
she
been lonely.
Has. I think she has.
When she brought out the water.
Yeah. Or even like staring, like, and I didn't catch you like over there, just like smile. I think she saw
something she liked and she wanted to go after it.
Okay.
That's how I interpreted it. She, you know, picked, she not here up. Just waiting on the sidelines.
I like that.
right.
You see it, you exactly. go get it. My exactly. man. All right.
So I respect her for that.
Well, Ty, you got anything? I know you said you was 3.5 seconds.
40 seconds.
No, nah, it was 4.5, first of all.
Okay, my bad.
yeah, you're right.
Three scenes, though.
Yeah. I could say Patrick is kind of like me in a sense of he's looking for something more in life. He's looking to, as far as a career path, as far as his decisions, he's looking for something bigger. Mm-hmm. I can definitely relate to that.
Trying to find that purpose.
Yeah, for sure. Trying to find a purpose, what you want to do in life. I think a lot of people can relate to that. However, he seems to be in a rush to settle down. He seems to be in a rush because of somebody to the left of me. I'm not that type. I definitely will spend a few years before I want to jump the fence and
put that up. He put emphasis on years.
When he left, they were 4 years in, though.
That is true.
Just for context.
Okay.
Mm. That's not rushing.
Damn, B.
Yeah.
Mm. 4 years.
So
I didn't went to college.
Crazy. Right. Got a bachelor's,
got a degree.
I done did a stint. 4 years. Yeah, I had another 2 years to that. We could have had some.
Good six.
Like get a master's in that thing.
Six is a good number.
You don't really know the person to the 6 year, Nadi. You don't really know the person to the 6 year.
Yeah.
For sure.
Facts.
I guess not, yeah.
All right.
I will say, too, my whole family was ex-military. Uncles, dads, brothers, everybody went to the military besides me. Ended up playing basketball, so it was kind of cool to play a character. Actually, in the series, the suit that I was wearing was my dad's suit from the Army. So I actually got to bring his uniform and wear it.
I didn't know that. Did it fit well?
I didn't know that either. But I found that out because a couple people hit me up. They was like, they started looking at the rankings on.
For real?
Yeah, they kind of knew what, like, who they was like, oh, that's a such a what? Like, you know what I mean? It's like, who military over there? So... I got a cousin that did some time over there in Iraq. That was the first person who witnessed that joint. He was like, peeped it. He was like, yo, okay.
So you the details, man. Details matter. Yeah,
some people really know what all that ranking and everything mean. And for now sure. He's a police officer now, so he still know all of that. That's what's up, though.
Yeah.
That's lit.
So, are you like your character? You killed anybody?
That's wild.
straight to the point.
Who said Cameron killed anybody, first of all? Like, you know what I'm saying? I didn't see any part where Cameron killed somebody. Did you see any part like where
he almost killed somebody in the office scene. You know, it took a while.
Hey, you got choked out, bro.
You got choked.
I'm good now.
Yoked up.
All right.
And you just took a pause.
Any of Cameron and me. Let's I think I see myself a little bit of myself and Cameron, and maybe in a way of uprooting and starting like a new life in another state. Like I'm originally from Maryland, I moved to Florida, and you know sometimes you do it, you got a fresh start. You really are a new person. Like you can be that. You can be like, you know what I'm saying.
As
a clean slate.
Nobody has
no history report on you. Mm-hmm. Like you clean with it. So I feel like that was cool. Like when I moved from Maryland to Florida, I didn't really change much. I'm still my goofy self, but the uprooted that. And then Cameron seems very like secretive or to himself. I'm definitely a person that doesn't like a lot of people in my business. Mm-hmm. So like I'm like, hey, let me ask me all these questions. You ask me all these questions for. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, or you know, people are like, oh my God, like, you living by yourself? You gotta go to hey, are you interested? Or are you just trying to like get this backdrop? Right.
That's so funny.
What are you doing?
You're such a public figure though, but you also really you
gotta
know, have care something about to yourself.
I gotta have something to myself. It reminds me of like MTV Cribs when like Mariah Carey did her house, she was like, I'm not showing y'all my bedroom, I want something to myself. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? So even the scene we shot, like the bedroom scene, that was my first bedroom scene I shot in years. Cause I kind of took my bedroom out of skits and out of everything. I'm like, oh, I'm just shooting, I'm not doing like no bedroom type of stuff. But that was like my first joint. So even watching the scenes around like family or friends or people looking at it, like it was so awkward.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, I didn't realize how long the scene was going to last. Like,
yo,
you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, wrap this up.
Tell me about it.
You know what I'm saying?
It.
I'm like,
you're talking about the last episode, right?
Yeah.
It was so long. Yeah. It was that big,
yeah,
man.
Yeah. There's a lot of
grief. Like, it don't last this long.
3.5?
I was like, ooh.
But it was a lot of breathing going on, too.
Yeah.
I was noticing. I'm like, dang, y'all was in there for real.
Was in there.
I was like, it was chilling.
I felt like
chilling.
I was in the bed with y'all.
Right. Yeah.
We need to run that back and see what the time run was.
Nah, it was at least like a minute 30. It was, it was
2:30? 2:30.
We was in the bed and I was just like, you know what I'm saying? Because I show people, like, yo, put it on right now. Like, put the series on, but then I forget, like, you know, I'm like, oh shit, like a kiss
and you
about
just
to
gotta
come
sit
up.
There and
and I'm watching like cousin and shit. I'm like, I'm like, all right,
I
come
told
on,
my
guys.
Mom to watch that.
That's
man.
What that's what I was about to go to. How do you tell your parents? How you prepare your parents for that?
I just tell her to watch it. I don't sit there and watch it with her.
Yeah, my mom be saying, she'll say weird shit like, y'all was kissing, wasn't you? Yeah, mom. You know what I mean? It's like the black mom vibe. So.
Right.
So that's what I see myself. Right. And the difference is, I don't know, I'm not a very angry or aggressive like type of person. And I feel like Cam got that rage in him.
I remember, should I tell him about that one time at that one pool party?
This guy's going
that
back.
That shit was crazy.
Wow.
That's the only time I really seen him.
A little apple juice was involved.
Yeah.
In that. Right. I was on that Henny.
He was on that juice.
Anything
that
was possible. Guys.
I might have
threw a security guard into the bushes.
Oh, that too? Oh, that part too. There was another part.
There was another time?
Where you suplex the
it was another time.
Oh, I did.
Multiple times.
Let's go to the next question.
He did what?
Let's go to the next question.
Like a shark.
Let's go to the next.
All right, we go.
And suplex
this
Puerto Rican kid into the pool. And then Buddy
with his phone.
He had his phone.
Yes.
Oh,
I remember that.
And Buddy couldn't do shit.
I had
he just getting out of the pool and embarrassed, wet. His
yes.
Like, hey, T, I ain't never seen inside of you, bro.
He never came back.
We're going to go on to the next question,
and now
guys.
He's calm.
Hold on. Wait,
I do. Does yoga and you
so
go
proud of your progression,
bro. Lattes.
On top of that.
So, all right. So, a follow up question to what y'all was asking, because I was interested. When I was seeing certain scenes, especially with y'all two, did y'all feel like there was any parts in the series where it was easier for y'all to do because you just tapped into who you were naturally? Like, this scene was good for me because I do this in real life.
All right, really quick, I enjoyed the workout scene when we were running. That was cool. I really like coming around the corner, running, jogging. Flirting, you know, the friendly, like, flirtatious competition.
That
looked
natural, too.
That was fun.
It read really natural.
And looked good. So I enjoyed that. I'm into fitness. So that was cool and fun. I feel like working out with your partner and shit, like, it's dope. So, sure.
Okay.
All right, next question. What were some of the funniest moments while filming?
I'm gonna let Ty go ahead because we popped out that little fight scene was funny over there.
Yeah, honestly, first thing that came to my head. As y'all know, I only was shooting for one day, so I didn't have many days. But I will say the fight scene probably was the most funnest. I was definitely excited and ready to see that scene because I was just curious how you guys did shooting, and it was fun to act it out. T's big behind was on top pause and.
Whoa. Yo, that was wild.
My big behind? was on top.
Hey.
That's crazy.
Yo, the setup. Nah, all but right, yeah. Right. So my natural self, I would not, you know, be in that situation. And so when you're acting in it, it's kind of, you have to take that like submissive role and kind of act like you're getting beat up while still being in a fight. This man going still.
Submissive?
Well, you could have let that ride. You could have let that one ride.
You submitted yourself to the scene?
No more. I ain't going to pause no more. I'm not pausing no more.
So I was instructed to get beat up, which I got beat up.
Yeah. We did that scene a few times, and I felt like each time it got like more and more outrageous.
Yeah.
Because
rug burns.
That was a long day for
us.
Yeah, that was a long day for us. So we kind of got a little... We started making that junk funny towards the end. Like when we did that for like the third or fourth time, like I was sitting there with the gun in my hand, like this is ridiculous.
That little ass revolver.
I just had to sit
there. That little ass revolver.
I just had to sit there with my eyes closed the whole time, like, listening to all the madness. I'm like, I want to peek open so bad.
Like trying to hold it with two hands.
Oh, God.
She couldn't see anything.
I couldn't see anything.
She had to stay in camera.
I had to watch it. My first time seeing it was watching it on Christmas.
Oh, man.
Even still, I couldn't see it in real life.
The fight scene was funny. Another funny
question. Who would win in a real fight between y'all two?
So that's another thing too about my character. Like I'm jacking you up on the wall.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? I thought we were going no more pause.
No, he said no more pause.
I thought we were no more pause.
He put the rule up.
I ain't say off, I say on.
That's flagrant.
So I put you up on the wall.
Putting you up on the wall is wild. That's wild.
You know what I'm saying? I'm fighting you on the carpet.
Facts.
I'm not into physical altercations. I use my hands for prayer and not brutality. I'm a kind person. So, you know, that was different. So in a real fight, I think Ty would have me.
Because of the military background?
Just in general. I'm not a fighter, man. I'm a Wusa type.
I ain't going to lie to you. That was different for me was that I'm usually like the aggressor.
Being
aggressed upon, like even in certain scenes, like
you can say the word,
man, I can say that. I'm a grown man, right?
Being choked out,
he gives aggressive daps. Like you know how somebody that's too hard with the handshakes and bring you in tight end. What's up?
Play defense.
Like Damon.
I coach defense.
I remember the first time I met you, sprayed my pinky when we said what's up.
Oh, right.
Nah, it was crazy. Yeah, not aggressive.
Come here.
I hate that. No, don't be like that, guys. Like girls hate like those overly like tight hugs and stuff like that. It make her back crack.
I give overly tight hugs?
You and talk to
I hate
you?
It. Oh, my
I've
God,
never
I
given a tight
it.
Hug in my life.
I hate
actually.
It.
You never did the hug and pick up?
No, I'm actually
oh
really good.
Oh, my God.
Hugger.
That's even Alan, worse
Alan probably
chest.
Alan no. probably does that, but I don't do that.
This guy give you dap ready, and try to start sparring. Like, see, hey, yo, come here. I mean, like,
yeah.
Bro, I haven't seen you in a long time.
The first time we did that scene, I wasn't prepared for how hard he was going to actually push me up against the wall. And there was you warned me, he warned me, and it took everything in me to stay character. Because it was like I was going to spark him, but I definitely would push him back. Like, hey, cut out.
You made the
hard.
Arthur fist.
But it made the scene really good, though. So
press coverage.
Man.
Had that.
I'm like, man, damn.
Okay, football terminology.
A funny part was, not to harp on or circle back to, but the damn sex scene. When we was in there and we was all in there shooting the sex scene. And, you know, we talking between the scenes, what we need to improve on, what we need to do better. And here goes Nadia is on top of me. You know what I'm saying? We did have clothes on, just to let y'all know at home. But still, you sitting on top of a guy, the movement alone. You know what I'm saying? I had to tell her, I was like, hey, stop moving. You know what I'm saying?
I forgot about that.
Just chill, bro. Just chill. I was like, hey,
please stop.
Stop moving. And then they thought that was hilarious.
I mean, you got to make it look real. Who doesn't move? Yeah. Come on now.
We was in between. You know what I mean? But still.
I'm just like, hey, pass me a water.
Right. So I was like, yo, I'm trying to give you quad. I'm giving you all quad right now. Take this quad.
Right. You have in your mind just like naked grandma. Like,
it's not even that. Like,
that won't work either.
I'm going
to
tell you.
Yeah, that don't work. Contrary to popular belief.
Yeah, that don't work.
That's a terrible thought.
Yeah.
You started off with naked, so that's... Never
mind. I got it.
Bring that back.
All right. So that was a funny part. I feel like that was funny.
That was
funny. You know what else was funny? Behind the scenes, like the little karaoke time that we did inside of the law office.
I don't know. What was that? You was there for it.
Yeah. And then we did a little freestyle, John. Mm. That was funny too. The behind the scenes stuff was funny. That was at your crib.
That's when you told me about the freestyle battle at FAU.
Yeah. He gonna tell that story.
Oh yeah, you already know. I won that bit.
Fun fact: we shot most of this like 2 years ago. So like,
yeah, this is shot in 2020, guys. That might be one of the questions.
That's like three.
Yeah, that might be. What's the next one?
What's the next one? Yeah.
Wait. Can I ask you one? Remember the club scene we shot?
Yeah.
Am I allowed to speak on?
Oh, yeah. What happened? He was actually in the club scene.
Yeah, I got one funny story. Yeah, wow. The club scene was
How do we do that?
I just told him, hey, don't turn around. Just give us your back. Pause.
Give us that nice.
Now it's getting ridiculous. Because
You see a lot of light skinned niggas with beards. So just turn around, bro.
Just because I'm light skinned with a beard don't mean he look like
and
me.
Except it was me. And he wasn't in the other episodes like that till that point. So I didn't realize that.
That's what I was worried about. Because while y'all was shooting that, I'm 6'6". So you see me in the back. In that shot, you see me in the back. And I'm like, yo, they're going to say something. He's like,
nobody said anything.
He was there the whole time.
Gotta be like,
I'm 6'6".
Tall dudes always announcing they We can see it, nigga. All right. It's cool.
But I mean, they can't see it in the camera right now.
Can't see it
I had a long day, man. Especially being 6'7". The day just be like mad long, B.
You gotta talk that.
It's hard to
maneuver
around my house being 6'6".
What's the next question? Let's keep it rolling.
This 5'7" girl approves of you saying that.
All right, so this is a good one for Nels. What do you love/hate about the character you played?
That's a long list.
But I know Nels. He tells me like, why this character so corny?
He was type corny.
I loved him.
Which I mean, that's okay. Like every squad got a corny dude, so you know it's okay. I don't think it was so much his corniness that bothered me. I think it's the way the character comes across is like he lives this life of corniness and is not aware that he's corny, and that aggravates me. People like that aggravate me in general. Mm. But I mean,
I think maybe he's aware of it. Maybe he just doesn't give a damn.
Let's hope so. We'll find out.
But do you?
Let's hopefully find out.
Do you know you're corny?
Me?
Like as an individual, if you're corny. How you know you're corny though?
Oh, you know. Your friends tell you, and you can come. You can have a God moment and be like, yeah, I'm kind of corny, bro.
Right.
How many awkward silence moments do you get in a day? Like people just looking at you like,
yeah. Right.
And remember, corny's still funny. It's just that you got to claim your corniness.
Yeah.
People mess with corny.
And you got to keep the ratio from corny. Yeah, there's to funny,
you know
like,
exactly.
Corny comes in a perspective when you're doing too much. Like, all right.
What I will say is what I did like about him, especially as the story unfolded, you know, whatever purpose he has for doing this, I do like the fact that he kept his word. Because, you know, he kept his word to his home, but, like, I'm going to look out. Now, we don't know what he's looking out for, you know what I mean? But he did.
I appreciate you, big dog. I appreciate
you. He ain't look out for the homie. He did. You know what I mean? He looked out for the homie. What I did like, and this probably answers, I'll save that because I'm pretty sure there's going to be a question I asked that. But what I did like especially was the interaction that he had when they finally showed the personal interaction with him. And, what's your character name again?
Lauren.
There you go. I didn't want to mess that up, but I like that interaction because it kind of showed a little bit more of his personality.
Which interaction?
The one where he's pretty much saying he's looking out and why he's looking out.
Oh, yeah.
No, in
at the office.
At the office, yeah. By her desk. Yeah.
Because Patrick told me to. That's why. And then he walks
off. Yeah. Sorry. I'll say that. Yeah. That's probably like, I got to give him a little bit more credit because all I do is bash Alan.
Avenge Alan.
What was the question again?
What do you like and dislike about
What do you love/hate about your character?
I love the drive for my character just to have like good work ethic. Just trying to keep his head down and get to it and get to the bag, get to the money. The hate part is...
He'll hate nothing.
No, I hate the short temper. Like, because it shows, as a man, it shows lack of control.
Okay.
Like, you have no control of yourself, bro. Like, you know what I mean? You're not in charge of your own self. That's a weakness.
I thought you were going to say his hair.
That's fucked.
that?
Crazy. Yo, shit. Oh, hey, yo. So my character's hair, guys. That's a hate. Every time I seen a scene, my hair was different. It was a different rusty two-strand twist. So hopefully next season, my hair is locked now, so we'll have that in order.
He was trying to find the right loctician. That's all. He knew in town.
Cameron moved from where? Atlanta?
Yeah.
They got a lot of locticians in
Atlanta. Did I really move from Atlanta, or am I lying to people and saying I came from Atlanta? All right.
Yeah, but I'm saying probably when he was in Atlanta, his hair was probably fox.
Who sent you?
You know what I mean?
But you gotta remember, he's staying
people want
to
know.
He's not trying to be out. Like
this is
that.
True too. So like, what's the purpose of getting a retwist if you ain't even had a house?
Every black woman that I know that watched was like, "Yo, this was good, but your hair though."
Nah, for real.
The hair, not even from episode to episode, but from scene to scene on some of them things was different twists. But
yo, they was paying attention.
I
ain't paying attention.
As a guy, you're not looking at my hair. Yeah, like, you know what I'm saying? So, all right, so that's my character. That's what I love slash hate.
He's like, I'm off.
What I love slash I don't know. I like how Lauren has like this innocence to her and this like what is it? She sees the good in people. Like, I love how she's like always batting for the underdog.
Is it innocence though?
Is it being naive?
Well, so that's that's the same thing that I dislike about her though. Ooh. That she does carry this naive trait, but
naivete about her. Hey, good work, my boy.
There's a balance I think that she has or that she needs to develop, but I don't know. Sometimes what's your good trait can also be your vice. So I don't know. I like some parts about that, but
All right. So, what do you love slash hate about your character?
We didn't really get a chance to dive too much into my character this season, so I think next season I'm definitely gonna be looking forward to what kind of character Tracy has to see. You know what I do reveal myself to be, but I think the biggest thing is the mystery aspect of my character. I think it's really interesting to kind of have that mystique. You don't know what kind of is happening, what's transpiring with him. So I'm excited to see what's going to unfold for season two.
So you don't think it's funny that you just left your girl of 4 years just to go to the army and didn't bat an eye, huh?
Hey, listen. I plead the fifth. No comment.
Mysterious vibes.
Mysterious vibes, yes.
Would you do that?
No, I wouldn't be in that type of situation. I think if I was going to be joining the military, she would know and be aware of it. And we'd be continuing from that. Now, if she wasn't about that, then we have a different discussion. So
that's lit. All right. You know, being 6'6", you know, she'd know if I left or whatever. You know what I mean?
Being 6'6" on a podcast. Is...
You know, she'd know if I
could. I should have never said my height.
That's the next one.
All right. Now we're answering some of the YouTubers' questions. This one is coming from Orville Scott. That's a very prestigious name, sounds like.
Orville Redenbacher?
Yeah. Ain't that man alone, man. Orville. What's the question?
Shout out to Orville.
They're going to start roasting out y'all.
They'll be like, oh, word.
All right, so Orville asks, who made the intro track and the intro cinematic? I want to give my compliments to them. The intro to this series is very tranquil to it. And, whoa. Let me start that over.
No, go ahead and rock it out. I'm gonna have the whole question on the screen too, so they can see. This is not an easy read from some of y'all.
Yeah. All right, all right. From Orville Scott, who made the intro track and the intro cinematics? I want to give my compliments to them. The intro to this series has this tranquility to it, a vibe about it that reminds me of Florida.
Okay.
Oh, dang. Shout out Steven Spielberg.
Been about the bop.
Yo, you know a nigga named Orville. He's gonna go deep. Pause. Yeah.
How did we get here?
What? How did you set
this
up?
So how did? So go ahead and answer his question.
Right, just threw an alley to himself.
This is clearly for me. Pretty much, I made the cinematics. You know, it's something that reminisced when I found kind of like the elements. I was like, yo, this shit gives me that vibe that. It's very mysterious, like, you know, my boy Ty said earlier. So it felt like the theme of this of the show. And then as far as the music goes, like, I listen to, like, tight beats, like, for the past 20 years, like, 10 years, like, every day. So I'm very in tune with music. So, like, once I found, like,
instrumental track, because mind you, that wasn't supposed to be the intro.
Right, right, right.
We just couldn't clear copyrights on the intro. My boy Legacy, shout out to him. He has an amazing song called Too Deep or Deep. It was gonna go crazy. If we get it cleared, it might be season two. But the instrumental I found,
it's a great song.
Just hit me up at Ricky Fane TV. I'll send you the link. You know, just don't buy the beat. We still want to use it. Right. We still got our license.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? All right. Yeah, but yeah. That's it.
Was that a two-part question?
Oh, that was the video game question.
We skip that.
Yeah. All right. So next one is.
Go ahead.
Can I touch on the editing?
Oh, for sure.
What did you use to edit? Was it Premiere?
Oh, yeah. Everything was Premiere. He used a little Final Cut for some other scenes.
Hold on. Don't call Final Cut a little bit.
He's a little bit of Final Cut.
I'm a Final Cut guy, too. Final Cut.
He used a little bit of Final Cut for some of the scenes McKinson edited. And then for the majority, everything else went through the Premiere Pro.
Okay.
Final Cut, right. Big Five.
Yeah, it's cool.
Next question.
Who's next?
I do my stuff on iMovie.
Oh,
thanks. Sorry about that.
That's like,
she's not good.
That's 2007.
It works. It works for what I needed to work for.
Better than what I started with.
Yeah, iMovie, boy. I remember my iMovie days.
Video Maker. That was my first YouTube editing software.
Video Maker?
Yeah.
What's the next one?
All right, so the next question is from Terrence. How did you guys come up with this series, and what were some of your favorite scenes to shoot? Well, I'll answer the first part. Pretty much when me and T were roommates back in the day, I was just on this web series high. Close Friends was going crazy. What was the other show I did with my boy? I can't remember the other one. Catching Feelings. Did Catching Feelings. And I was just on one of those creative highs. I was like, yo, we could do this. We could do this.
Yeah.
Boom, boom, boom. Because here's a little
pumping
fun fact.
Pumping out a script a day.
This is the second time we shot this.
Facts. Fact. We shot this years back. And scrapped everything. Remember when you was like, yo, why the series never came out? I'm like, we about to reshoot. Remember?
When I did the scene in the Jeep.
By the trash can.
Yes.
And I punched you.
Yes. I practically got hit in that one. So better we matured.
They both had brush cuts back then.
Was y'all playing the same characters?
Yeah, we playing the same character. We had somebody else playing Julius character. Yes. Shout out to Harley.
Who was Lauren? Who was Lauren?
We had a little Spanish chick or something.
Oh, yeah.
Remember?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hold on, man. Relax. The chick was.
We were still living in.
What you mean? Like
we
you
still living in Delaware?
You
wasn't
acted
it?
Like you didn't know.
Yeah,
like,
you're
like,
crazy.
I ain't looking like this.
Wow.
You ain't looking at it now.
That's wow.
This man lying.
We did shoot this before.
I forgot about that. You're so right.
Why did it end up being scrapped back then?
Well, it was a lot of moving parts.
And cast. We had some other cast options.
Yeah, different cast options and then kind of different casting vibe for a little bit.
Our hair grew.
We had a dope truck back then. Remember that red truck we had?
I lost my hair.
Shout out.
Yeah, we had a couple of elements.
Damn. Yeah.
And then, I also hit a wall of burnout. I was burnt out a little bit, too. So that played into it also.
From the high of the Close Friends.
Yeah, a lot going on, yeah.
I was...
And you just came back from L.A.?
Yeah. No, this was before going to L.A.
Oh.
Yeah, it was. It was before you cleared it, yeah.
This was probably 2 years before going to L.A.
Mm-hmm. Facts.
Because then I ended up doing... After that, I did No Love Lost by myself. The whole thing. I had to do audio. I had to hold the camera. I had to edit. I casted everybody. I paid everybody. Mm-hmm. Bro, it was a lot. But, yeah. 2016. That was 2016, yeah. It was a lot. But, yeah, then 2017, I moved to L.A.
All
right. Yeah. All right. So then the second part is from Terrence. He says, what were some of your favorite scenes to shoot? Let me answer first. Mine was the choke scene.
Okay.
That was fire.
In the office?
Yeah. That was fire.
I love all the office scenes. It looked magnificent in there. The lighting was great.
Those are fun. Those are definitely fun.
Shout out to Cruz.
Yeah. That shit was
for the connect.
Oh, yeah. She was.
Yeah. She can't do.
I love the production value. And then the other scene that I love was the barn scene or the scene with the vertical shots where you looked in and then you saw somebody escaped from somewhere.
Yeah.
That was also fire. Shout out to Ken with that shot. But yeah, how about you guys? What was y'all favorite shots?
You want to say it?
Yeah, we'll go last.
Yeah. You mentioned earlier the the jogging scene, that was fun because it was, I like, you know, working out as well. So it felt like real, you know, because we actually were gearing up, but I don't know who idea was. It probably was yours to actually like jog before we started
you
shooting.
You gotta get that good lather, get that heart rate going.
And you had the spray bottle.
Yeah.
I don't even think we really needed the spray
bottle. No, we was rolling by then.
We was up, and I was keeping up with him too. So I was like, all right, let's do
now
it.
Now we're going left.
Aquarius, we're am I right?
So that was good because relax. That was probably, that felt the most natural. This is crazy. That felt the most natural. So, because I didn't think I was like in a character or in a role. Like, it was just like very seamless to me. So, I think that was one of the best ones. And, you know, it was, you know, a good day, good weather, all that good stuff. I like being outside. So, all
right.
You said she got them rockets on your head.
Yeah. My favorite scene, real quick, is with my coworker outside of the work truck throwing stuff in the back. You know what I mean? Just him comedically saying, we got to get you out of the house. We got to get you out on a party scene. We got to get you out and have a good time. Most of the time when you have a homie or a coworker trying to get you out of the house and like, come on, we got to go party, shit don't never end well. And ultimately, that's what happened with me. So that's like because that's like a real joint. The fellas always, hey, come on, man, we got to get out. We got to do this. We got to get you out of this rut. And but that was like so realistic and genuine. You always got that like, and some titties. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Like, that was a great line. Hey, shout out to Julius. That was
he
did that. Shout out to Julius.
He did his thing for sure.
So that was like my little favorite, like, or funny. Like, that was a fun scene that we shot out that. We literally, like, just found a random truck, had some cones, and all of this stuff was shot, like, guerrilla style. So it was cool. We had a good time. Good, yeah.
That wasn't y'all truck?
Absolutely not. What the hell are we getting that truck from?
Bro, oh, this looks nice.
Let's get that.
Seriously, there was like a lawn care sign on the truck.
Hey, listen, man.
Yeah, see the phone number.
We
had phone number.
We
checked
it. Yeah. Perfect. Wait a minute. What?
There was a number on the truck. We hit the number.
Yeah.
I thought that was like an uncle's truck or something.
Nah, man. We made
no, it. But like that was a real truck that y'all just found.
The worker's truck that they was using.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It was cool. It had everything. We
pulled
stuff out there
we
so you
just
throw it in.
Yeah. How y'all found this truck?
Bro.
They got their ways, man. They chilling.
We got a cruising like, hey, I like that right there. Right.
That's are you kidding
truck.
Me? It was just an unattended truck.
It was right there. It was like, we got to do a lawn care scene.
Worked out perfect.
Where can we shoot it?
But what's crazy
and we reshot that scene.
Yeah.
That came out so much better.
Yeah.
Dang.
And what's crazy is with location scouting, like.
Hold on, give me that mic. Well, you can go ahead.
Everything we needed was like right around each other. Like, I'm not gonna say too much, like where bodies went.
Right.
Or like, you know, where you held the bodies.
Mm-hmm.
For me, the most fun shots or the most challenging shots was when you guys were jogging. I was.
Oh, yeah. Like backwards. Yeah. You
know? Oh,
back pedal, baby.
Oh,
and had it
that
was boy there
like a DB.
Yeah, so I'm kind of like.
It started raining after a while, before we started.
Loose man.
Any movement shot. I hate stagnant or like the static shots. Anything that was movement, you know, like it was challenging to me. Y'all don't know, like it's a mental, it's like an Olympics going on in my mind. Like, okay, I just need to make sure I don't fall.
Mm-hmm.
Things like that. That's all I'll say.
So that bedroom scene wasn't challenging for you?
Oh, I'm telling you.
Which one?
I did.
You did audio. Look, doing audio for kissing scenes and stuff. Oh. That's like when people chew with their mouth open.
Mm-hmm. No, I get what you're saying. The sound
there was
effect.
A lot of kissing.
There was a lot of kissing.
I got loud lips. So there you can hear that popping and shit. I got my lips
was
is just
literally
like
outside of it being a long scene, I was like, why is there so much kissing?
Yeah.
And to be honest, like these were like mild sex scenes.
It was mild.
I ever shot.
It was mild.
This was like cookie cutter as possible.
And you definitely made it a point to say that when I was like
season two, the finale where Nigel, man.
Yeah. I've seen some of your work.
That was crazy.
Dirty work, man.
Scary.
But no, even but we kind of discussed the scenes, the sex scene beforehand, because I was like, if we do a sex scene,
it's based off the comfortability.
And I want to be tasteful. You know what I mean? Because there's still other stuff you could do. You could do like central kissing. It could be a pillow grab or like grabbing of the sheets.
Yeah.
Different stuff like that. And to leave more to the mind, which sometimes is even better than just straight
showing it.
You know what I'm saying? Like, so I think it came out good.
Little drill work.
Yeah. Sometimes
what's up?
The scene where you're walking think it's blurred. You're walking towards the camera crazy. In the bedroom.
Ooh, I like that one.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, okay.
That
yeah,
close
yeah.
up.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's kind of like.
That was fire.
Yeah. That was a good, that was a good lit. Shot.
Or like Rick giving me like freedom to do whatever I pictured. The most uncomfortable shot was when you were placing your ear on the door. I don't know what.
It was a TV. We pulled the flat screen off yeah. the TV off a little bit, and then you shot behind the flat screen.
It was very uncomfortable because it was like a small space.
Yeah.
Outside of that,
that's what's up.
Oh, the fight scene was cool too.
Hell yeah.
To make it look like you're getting punched or hit. Moving the camera around mm-hmm. up and down to give the illusion that, you know, something's happening that's not
nah,
right.
Nah, T was punching me
that
for real.
Cool.
Please stop it, guys.
No, them punches right. was not landing.
Please stop
it. So,
thank you.
I liked, no, you like I said. You should have.
That's crazy.
But
that's wild. Not I thought we was friends.
Not at 100%.
Nah, that's cool.
Like,
say what you feel.
Right. He's like, you should have asked me.
Sure.
Now, you know if I punch somebody and they're 6'6".
David, you're great. It's a bad day.
Hey, look, hey.
It's
like Mike Tyson fight when you fight that bitch.
Oh, what is that? The knockout game?
Yeah, yeah.
Soccer Bob. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Let me see. All right, I'll keep it short. The scenes in the office, like I said, with Alan and Lauren, that scene was fun just because it was a little bit of pettiness in there. So I was able to tap in that a little bit. That was fun. The awkward scenes in the beginning where he walks into the house and he's talking about the light bulbs
yes.
and then
mm.
you
I love
yourself
that.
And I'm like, yeah, like, bypass him.
We about to get into it.
Right there.
Yo,
he hits me with
body
the,
that
he hits me with the size and he goes, excuse me. And he walks by and then she's upset because obviously Alan is cock blocking.
Yeah.
And I try to make it an emphasis to have like a smirk to make it seem like he knew exactly what he was doing. To kind of like, you know.
Yeah.
Because the way that the script read out, I was like, okay, he's really on some shady vibes right now.
You did something with the editing too, because that shit was zooming on each person. It was like a clock zoom.
Yes, yes.
That was kind of, that's Ken thing. He likes doing the little, it's kind of like.
That shit went hard.
It's exactly. It's documentary vibes. But if you use it properly, you could give it still that dramatic.
Yeah, it went hard. I was like, damn.
It kind of gave me like novella type.
Right, right. Like you coming into the person.
Captain Phillips.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
Captain Phillips got it from there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
The,
I'm the captain.
I'm the captain.
Yes. Okay. The first scene to me was just funny because we did that, I think, twice. We did the practice and then we just did that scene twice. The first time was super awkward, but I think that was a good introduction for me because I was like, oh, it's just going to be awkward in general. So might as well just live in it.
The
so
light
the second,
bulb scene you're talking
The second time around, I was like, okay, I'm here now. I know exactly.
Right.
What I need to put out or whatever. So that was cool. Those scenes to me, those two scenes was the best.
Boom. All right. So next question is from DJ Waller. How many seasons are you planning to do? One. And will the series be submitted to any film festivals?
12 seasons. Straight up.
Well,
I don't know show that been on for 12 seasons.
Grey's
Anatomy's
been like
11, 14.
Oh, for real? Yeah. I don't count that though. I'm talking about like a show. Like,
I mean, The Simpsons been off for.
Yeah, that shit don't count either.
I'm
talking about give me like a Breaking Bad.
Breaking Bad was how many? It was like
they
seven
have a
seasons.
Firm ending on those type of shows.
Right.
It's like
Sons Dexter.
Of Anarchy, Sons of Anarchy was about seven seasons.
Yeah.
All right, never mind. Seven seasons.
Make sure you tune in.
Hey, that's me. Seven seasons, 22 episodes.
Seven.
Give me Walking Dead. That's some Walking Dead seasons.
For me personally, I want to do at least three for sure.
Mm-hmm.
And then if it gets even crazier, then hey, we got to keep going while the iron's hot. Like
five seasons.
You know what I mean? Like,
it's getting
shorter and shorter.
Well, the fans really control how long it goes. The more engagement, the more following, the more support, the more donations, shit like that. That's the driving force. If you guys enjoying it, we're going to keep putting it out. You know what I'm saying? And,
mm-hmm.
and like me and McKinson like to do, every season we want it to be bigger than the first. Like, so the more resources, the more... people we meet, the more talented people we could bring on, the better, you know what I mean? Because then we could have better series. And then do we plan on submitting it to festivals? Of course.
It's already in the works.
It's already in the works.
Sundance?
Damn, Sundance, you went big as hell.
Nah. Maybe season two. We got
Utah?
It's Utah. I'm going to go to Utah.
Yeah,
Utah noise.
Yeah,
we go snowboarding too.
But Sundance eventually, for sure, for sure. But everywhere else, hell yeah. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
All right, because Sundance is this, like, next month.
February, yeah. February, yeah.
No, January. January 28th.
Yeah, that shit about to be lit. All right, so the next question is from... All right, that's a production question. We're going to skip that one. From Kate Nick. Okay. What do you think is the hardest scenes to film? And then who besides your character you played would you say is your favorite?
Everyone knows my favorite character.
Oh, yeah, you know. So you might as well go first. Go ahead.
Well, what was the most difficult scene for you to film? And who's your favorite character?
Okay, well, come back to me because I don't know my difficult scene.
My difficult scenes, I think a difficult scene for me was when I had the shovel and I was like, it looked like I was strangling someone and I was hella aggressive. Outside, yelling, just looking up, like it just looked like just rage. That was very difficult because, you know, you can have rage, you could be upset. But you can overdo that as well. You know, anyone who has rage is still like that calming moment where, like, you know, whether it's the calm before the storm or just coming out of your rage, just like the heavy breathing, the perspiration, the sweating, the heartbeat, like just all of that. And just to have that look in my eyes. And then I think my favorite character, I like Alan. Surprisingly.
What?
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I like Alan. I like your character. You know why I like your character? Because not because you like taking up for the homies and that's your word, but like you're genuine self. Like I feel like you're a kind person. And sometimes being overly kind and nice is considered corny.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying, which is sad.
He's a nice guy.
Came over trying to help with light bulbs and be polite, and is getting
where's my hug
in the comment section.
He's gonna destroy
destroying him. Oh, he's so corny. Trying to protect you, make sure you're not talking to or dating a killer.
Yo,
and people are still like, he deserves everything he gets.
You know the
saved
worst
from the pedophile.
The worst part, and I'm a high school teacher. So my students have seen the series.
I know they'd be looking at like,
killing me.
They'd be all like, right, Mr. Allen. Like, all right,
Coach,
Mr. Allen.
They'd be like, Coach A, right, Allen. They'd be like, Allen is lame.
Hey.
They'd be like, is that really who you are?
I'd be like, no. That's who you are after school?
No, it's not. They'd be like, I don't know, Coach A. Right. This
Coach A.
They be killing me.
Other schools pull up. Yo, y'all got Allen coach?
we about to run
it up. Allen?
His lame out of football coach? Oh, he
21
done.
Scum.
Blur.
All right. Who's your favorite character, though?
Ooh. I'm not going to hold you. In the beginning, it was Lauren. In the beginning, I was like, damn, kind of like.
But then she tried you at the office.
I feel you. I was like, ridiculous. It ends up in the end being Kim because there's so many layers, right? There's just so much. There's so much to him. And it's like at the end, you're still like, damn, what is he hiding? Right? And you can look at the different perspectives and see like he's kind of, is he a loner? Is he not a loner? Does he have an agenda? Does he not have an agenda? So that's definitely, he was my favorite character towards the end. I guess the answer to the first
mix and
part.
Match. He mix and match the characters.
Yeah. Right. Mm. The first question was difficult scenes.
Yeah.
For me, because I've never, this is my first time doing it, is definitely when I would read what I'd have to do and realize like, okay, this is not even remotely close to who I am. So I had to like figure out. And the good thing was luckily we got it ahead of time for me to kind of like figure out or see like shows with that same scene or whatever and kind of see what emotions were being evoked and stuff like that. Like the office scene, I'm going out guns blazing. I'm throwing punches immediately.
You told me he was like Alan in high school though. So we had a little bit of Alan.
A little bit of Alan. No,
that's how he got the role.
Right, exactly. No, honestly, the part that I locked in with him where I was like, okay, I can see this was pretty much how loyal he was. He was at the end of the day, it just seems like he just wants to be a nice person. So like the thing about it is, like I said again, is delivery. He don't read the room. Yeah. You need to read the room and be like, all right, this is not my area to be in, but he seems to be in all the sauce.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And we'll see what happens season two at all with him being in all the sauce.
All the sauce.
But yeah, the difficulty was definitely where I had to kind of like do something that I couldn't exactly attach a life experience to. Mm-hmm. Where it's like, oh, like I've been in this situation before. I know how to play this.
You never
like
get a lot your ass beat? You couldn't get a... attention.
Well, when you're a nice guy, you don't get in fights.
Yeah, I mean, I've been in fights, but
call the cops. I
swung back. Mm. Like I didn't swing back here. Like I'm not worried about
getting
my,
get fought.
Right. Like, I ain't worried about. I never been worried about getting my ass. Well, you get your ass. It is what it is. But to have somebody walk inside your office,
walked you down.
Tell you to hang up your phone.
Told you to hang up the phone, and you actually hung up the phone.
Back to you,
and yes, he takes you to corner.
I'll call you back.
Like, yeah, that junk was crazy. And then him trying to play it off.
Hang that shit up, man.
Right.
Like, hey, hit that button.
You know what I mean? I was like.
Get that.
Right.
Oh, man. But,
yo, this nigga sold you out, though.
Allen
sold you out as soon as he
came. Oh, quick.
Hey, whatever Lauren told you.
She's lying. She's lying.
Nigga, yo, are you still team? All right.
It'd be like that.
It'd be like, she don't know. She didn't know that happened.
I didn't know that until I watched it.
Didn't know, right?
Yeah.
Speaking not from the perspective of Lauren, but just the perspective of Nadia. Oh my God, Allen was my favorite. Everything that T already said, but there was so much to that character that I could see me building a friendship with. He's, you know, loyal. He rides for his friends. He rides for his dogs. You know, he keeps his word. He, you know, there's just like this huggable, lovable quality to him that he carries. And you just want to be nice to him and like just go on a Starbucks outing with
Where's
him.
Where's my hug at?
Now, with that being said, she just gave you the definition of a friend zone guy.
Yeah. Facts.
Facts.
This is the guy that she gonna be
He's
like.
He's the ultimate friend.
You're still
yeah.
a pal.
Allen ain't getting no poons.
Allen ain't getting no play.
Allen can go to the mall with me if he wants. Help me pick out my outfit that I'm wearing tonight with that man that I'm going on a date with.
Oh,
that's tough.
That's crazy.
You're going to send her out to get the ankles not loose. Hope she has a good time.
Oh, you just destroyed Allen.
Guys, don't be Allen.
Don't be Allen.
Definitely don't be
Allen. I love Allen. Because while we're walking through the mall, we might be, you know, like lock arms, you know, like the pretzel lock. And then people might think that I'm his girl.
Yeah.
So.
You'd be like, yo, I thought that was your boyfriend. Who, Allen?
No.
In front of him.
Yeah.
Front of him is crazy. Allen's standing there like this with the bag of his ass. Prince.
How you doing?
But Allen's watching me try on that lingerie at Victoria's Secret. And like, is this good? How does it look from this angle?
Don't be Allen. Yeah, because Allen just going to sit there and be like, oh, it's lovely. The curves look great. Out of here.
He's really going to enjoy this one.
I love him. No, but seriously, outside of me wanting an Allen as a real life friend, if this fits your quality or type of archetype, please let me know because I would love to be your best friend. But
yeah, you definitely in Atlanta. You got a plethora of people to choose from.
Essentially, she's looking for a homeboy that she can friend zone and like pretty much like bring you around and lure you and stuff like that.
And she going
to get I'm looking for a ride or die G friend.
She wants a scouting report.
Like when a dude hit on it and she not interested, hey, I act like you're with me.
Right.
Yeah, you're going to have all
I never do that.
Or if the date cancels, you get the text like you're trying to watch the movies.
I was out with a friend
Stand
one
by
time,
us, man.
And I was out with a friend, a guy friend, and I got another guy to buy me and my guy friend a drink.
Yeah,
so
I'll do that.
Stick
so
with
now you're not only in a friend zone.
Stick with me, Allen.
Like you're a little hoe.
Oh my goodness.
You gonna get free dinner.
You became the thotty friend.
Like a thot.
Oh,
no. Yo, he treated you like a homegirl. That's
yeah. You gotta thank him like
see
this.
What these DMs look like after this.
No.
Oh my goodness. He hungry too?
All right. Yeah. No, that's literally how it was.
Oh my goodness.
Hey, appreciate the drink.
And then
the
drink,
bro.
He accepts the drink and drinks it.
It's a free drink.
Straw.
And look at you.
Off the side.
Appreciate that drink, bro.
Hey, he's gonna finish his drink. Be like, hey, can you hold that for me? And then take her to dance
while you're holding. Oh, and you're holding both drinks.
Hold them both.
Holding the drink.
And then you're confusing the drink because it's the same drink.
You sipped off his drink.
Which Coke and rum is mine?
Think it to yourself. I wonder if he gonna ask me to dance next.
No.
Am I up?
No, that's not how it
went. Damn,
not
it.
Next
question.
That's not how it went.
You slaughtered Alan.
Oh my God.
We love Alan.
Alan needs to kill somebody season 2.
We passed the 1 hour mark.
Probably.
No, we about like 10 minutes.
Okay. He's going to need to kill somebody season right. 2 for sure to get his thug back.
Sea Wars asks, will season 2 go more in depth on Cameron and Lauren's previous relationships before the events of season 1? Quick answer, no.
Okay. Damn.
We're progressing, and we're going to kind of see what happened. A lot of questions will be answered, but we're going to pick up like nothing missed a step. Like, we never missed a step. We're going to see where they are now.
Wait a minute. So how are we going to do that? We're not going to touch on, Lauren and Patrick?
Yeah, that's a big part of season 2.
That was her previous relationship,
but not the backstory too much.
No.
We're not gonna give flashbacks, but we'll unravel stuff in conversation.
Through conversation,
I
okay.
See what you
through
mean.
Through them talking, through him talking with his best friend Alan, and different stuff like that. So,
I would love to see how them three became friends. Alan, Lauren, and Patrick.
Them two are friends, and Lauren is his girl.
Okay, and Lauren and Alan are friends.
I mean, by default. It's like a bonus friend.
Yeah, a neighbor
it's
friend.
It's like, that's my dog's girl.
Alan
my dog
coming
left,
over here to change my light bulbs. He my friend.
He's just a neighbor, though. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, just seem like
he's changing in your neighborhood. That's not your friend.
Man, I had a girl ask me to change a light bulb once. I said, you need a man.
Yeah.
I said, this is why you need a man.
Exactly.
I'm not changing your light bulb.
Exactly.
She didn't want you to change
it. Nah, but still, I wasn't doing it. I wasn't even doing her man quality type stuff. I'm not changing your light bulbs. Call your daddy.
You would have cleaned out her cobwebs in the gutters?
Nah, absolutely not. Not on the joking side and not on the real side.
Yeah, I was like, cobwebs in the gutter.
Gutter.
Wow. All right. Real quick.
Where are we going?
Real quick. I take that back. We'll do a little montage to catch everybody up on y'all relationship.
I would like to be caught up.
Yeah, so we'll do that. We'll give you guys a montage so y'all can kind of get
look
that
at that,
head.
Guys.
We need
you heard
to
find, it here first.
We need to see the background because considering that he's 6'6".
Yeah,
you know what I mean. Like
wow,
those things.
But,
that's important.
Y'all ain't gonna let that go, huh?
No, we're not. Damn,
That's wild.
When you're 6'6", relationships are hard.
Yeah. He over there on the podcast like.
Well, when you're 6'6",
I got a shoebox under the mic.
I mean, 6'6", and in the military, I mean, that's tough. That's tough sledding.
Earned your stripes.
You the first one going.
You might have a couple. Never mind.
And he went the ball route, the basketball route,
Is that a reveal for season 2?
Maybe you have some kids. I don't know.
Hoop dreams. Hoop dreams and kids? That's crazy.
All right. Next question.
Crazy.
This one is for Nels from Coden. They asked, was Nels scared when you gripped him up real quick in the office?
Pause.
he did grip you. He put them grippers on you.
Relax.
Standing I was scared for you, brother.
Was I scared? No. I was
like, standing on business.
Actually, I think the second time we did the scene, I almost laughed. Just because, again, like I've known T for a while. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't see that situation unfolding. And then on top of that too, like I'll whoop his ass for real.
Hey.
I mean on God, like my hands.
You know
are
when
real.
You're nervous, you start laughing at shit. You start to kiki.
Is that what that is?
Palms were sweating. Had that boy like this.
Yeah.
That's like close. Fact. Talking in his ear.
Yeah, he's talking a lot of trash.
See, hung
now,
his phone
now I'm
up.
Mad to fight him for
hung
real
his phone
so
up.
We know what it is.
Everything. Let's go.
No, but I wasn't scared. But it definitely was an experience.
You told me you was like, yo, I ain't know you was going to push me up against the wall that hard on the first date. You
didn't
say that?
I did say that. But that was more like a threat for the second one. Like, hey, yo, my boy. Like, I didn't know you was going to do that the
that
first time.
That might be true.
The second time, we might have a problem.
And I ain't finna lie. I think I asked you, hey, you good, bro? Because that shit kind of got us off guard. We like, oh, shit.
No,
we
I was
filming that. It was like, you straight? You
no,
like,
I was good. Yeah. No, I was good.
Had to fix his collar and shit.
It was real. It was. Listen, I played football, so the physicality wasn't a problem. Okay, like I thought it was very authentic. Mm. That and the reaction that we got when it happened let me know that it was a good scene.
That's like the most important part.
Like, because, you know, to see them to be like, oh, shit. Yeah. And afterwards be like, bro, you straight? I was like, no, I'm good. Like, that's what you want out of that scene. You
and know
what
the scene was dope, too, because, you know what I'm saying? You're not like a smaller guy. We like the same height, same size vibe. So,
what, 5'9"?
Yeah, 5'9" and a half.
6'6", you know, you're all 5'9" and 6'6", guys.
Right.
I think he's slightly taller than you.
I'm 6'2". Just putting that out there. Let me announce my...
So,
are you like
6'4"? No, I'm like 6'3", man.
He's taller than me.
But that made the scene better. Because, you know, it's hard to shoot those type of scenes when someone's, like, dramatically shorter or something like that. And I feel like with that, you know, even though your character's, like, a more of, like, a cornball type of guy, it still didn't look like I was bullying you because it wasn't a big size differential.
Yeah. Right,
so
right.
So that added to it.
So
I ain't come across it like, man,
it's a tall cast.
He wouldn't do this to somebody that was his size. Like, you know,
right,
so that was cool,
no,
too.
That's true.
I'm not going to lie. It's a tall cast because most of you guys are, what, six foot and up? Mm-hmm. 6'6".
So you had to hold that. Boom.
Yeah, even now you're 5'7".
Okay.
That's
crazy.
Yeah, even now that's tall for a girl. Yeah.
To be honest, I was more worried about the...
5'7" is not average, my dear.
Yes, it is.
For a man, it is. For 5'7",
it is. No, 5'9" is average.
Average height for a man is 5'9". Average height for females or women
5'4"?
Is 5'4".
5'4", yeah.
5'4", 5'4". 3 inches,
you're tall.
Agree to disagree.
Let me ask Nels a question.
Agree to disagree.
That's fair.
That's that lawyer in her.
Yeah,
she got it.
No, I mean.
So speaking of fear, the question is about you being scared. So when you question or did she question you, or you question her in the office?
It was me questioning her.
No. When you kind of put the blame on her. Oh no, it was T. Whenever you was like, don't believe anything she said. Was your character scared in that moment? Is that the reason he kind of snitched on her?
Yeah.
Yeah, he was. Yeah. He was scared for sure.
Under the bus.
Yeah, but that's again, that's what you're trying to put out there, mm-hmm. right, in that situation, which is the reason why he went and snitched in the first place. And on top of that, like, he ain't even know what he was going to say to begin with. So for him to just outright just put her out there like that, yeah he's definitely.
And you got to think, the stuff he researched and found out about Cameron.
Yes, correct.
And you already know what I'm capable of.
And now he's in the office.
And now I'm in the office, close quarters, 1v1. Like, you don't know what's popping. Like,
correct.
I don't want to be the next. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, of course, mm-hmm. no matter what size you are, if you run into a killer, you're going to be like,
you're going to be a little concerned, for sure.
You're going to be a little like, okay. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, that played a part, too.
That character development was there. So, like, you know, you had to continue playing that out. Like, you knew what was going on. And then on top of that, I think in the scene, you did a really good job of kind of like, putting out the silent rage thing.
Mm-hmm.
So when he comes in there looking like he's about to do something crazy, you ain't just going to sit there and be like, yeah, how can I help you?
Like, you know, the person I immediately thought about in that scene with like the rage and the potential to harm someone was Tupac and Juice. Like, you know, in the elevator. So he looked like, it was almost like a smirk, like, hey,
I'm
gonna get with you, man. I'm gonna get with you. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, but that scene, the elevator scene in Juice with Tupac is just like unreal. Like, it was like, yo, that's crazy.
That's iconic.
With people around. Like, you're looking at somebody
and
like.
He's just looking at him the whole time.
Right. Didn't I think that's weird? Like, a nigga just in the elevator, he's facing everybody, but he's just staring at you.
Yeah, sir. And the exit right there, like, what's going on?
Oh, goodness. That's a good one.
You can't run. How long did it take you guys to. This is from Bapo. He asked, how long did it take to shoot all the scenes? It pretty much took us like, we shot mainly on weekends.
Mm-hmm.
It probably took us like, in actuality with everything, probably like really 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Really. But that's really like.
But we didn't shoot like weekends, guys. It wasn't like during the week. It wasn't like consecutive days.
So it probably took us like 16 days. Total. Mm-hmm. And then we did like a couple of days of reshoots. But those were quick days. So. Yeah, it didn't take us too long. It just, the editing always takes forever. You know how it goes. And then the last question is from Crystal. It's spelled with a C-H or whatever. Where does season 2 leave Cameron and Lauren's relationship if Patrick is back? I'll let y'all kind of brainstorm. Because I know where it was about to happen. Go ahead.
She the one. She got all the answers. She's in control.
Oh, man, you guys got to tune in. I want to know, too. I don't know. But what I hope for is that, you know, I hope Lauren figures her shit out. And I hope she's privy to information that she was not privy to before. Mm. And then she could really make a sound, informed decision on which man she wants to pursue a life with.
Got options. She got options.
Just based off of getting the full spectrum of the facts.
Hey, ain't no options. I'm back.
We gonna see.
Hey, you know how it happens.
You up
sometimes.
And left.
Hey,
you up and left.
Some people get injured and lose their starting spot. Quarterbacks go to, look at Tom Brady. Became one of the greatest of all times because Bledsoe got hurt.
Shout out to Drew Bledsoe.
Damn, Bledsoe.
Shout out to Drew.
It's only, it's
look
only
how Mahomes
one
came in.
Room. Yeah. Shout out to Alex
only
Smith.
One man in her life, so y'all gotta just.
Joe Flacco. Lamar Jackson. Oh, yeah. Shout out to Joe.
Shout out to Joe. Joe still ball. You could ball elsewhere.
Yeah.
You, that's crazy. Take your ass somewhere else. Go to Cleveland City.
References.
I've been serving this country for 4 years.
Stay with us. Stay with us. Stay with us.
Yeah, we lost a little bit.
Good
stay with us. Just
heavens.
Smile.
Correct.
Good heavens.
Y'all should just fight.
Here's a better question. Where do y'all hope? She told us what she hopes happens.
Mm-hmm.
What do you hope happens for your character with that love triangle situation?
Well, I thought she was being faithful and waiting for me. So to find out you are cheating on me, I'm probably going to say it's over. All right? Probably. I want nothing to do with you anymore.
not with the eyes. That face, too.
We try to let you know.
He said, I'm out.
Mm. Yeah, what you got to say about that?
Gotta take it.
No, wait a minute. Lauren knew that he was still alive, right?
Right.
Remember, no, remember
well,
she doesn't know.
She doesn't know what happened. Because remember, I was like, contact, oh, he went out like a hero. And then you was like, well,
like,
I think he's still
alive. I said he's not dead.
Yeah, yeah.
I think
he's still alive, right?
So she doesn't know.
No,
she's like, he's not dead.
Not
I just,
dead.
Yeah, she's like, not, yeah.
I just lost contact with, what?
Right.
Pick up your phone.
Right.
Pick up your phone, baby.
You think she's just going to wait around?
I don't care if you got the whole army, a whole country shooting at you.
You think you're just going to wait around?
I'm calling you. Respond.
I ain't have no reception out there.
I don't care. Find some.
They call him.
You scrolling on Instagram somehow.
The crazy part is, you know, even though he's been MIA, their communication has been on level zero. She met Cameron. Things are going well, even though she has outsiders trying to interrupt that. You know, we having romantic nights. We drinking wine together. We're intimate.
You know, up the house.
I'm fixing the house.
I'm cooking his mom's
she's cooking
gumbo.
My mama gumbo.
Yo, the mama
she's in the kitchen.
Her
home
trying.
She's trying.
Yeah.
Trying.
You know, we're communicating, and I'm opening up to you, having deep conversation in the bed, laid up, cuddled up.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me? We baking a cake.
I'm sure you got a toothbrush at
we
my crib.
We baking it. Oh, definitely.
Ooh.
And some drawers.
Let's some drawers. So you walking
he
in the
got
drawer.
The top
drawer. You know, I got some of your shorts.
They in the top drawer. Folded.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The top drawer. Folded and left ironed.
Mm-hmm. Did you sniff the drawer?
Folded and ironed is crazy.
Okay. It's only right.
I got to sniff them to know if I got to watch them or not.
That's crazy. That's nuts.
Literally. What's happening right now?
That's nuts.
Literally nuts.
Hey,
yo.
Still in character?
Yeah. So my thing is, how can we go in the distance and do all of that, and she even think that just going back to him is gonna be a thing. I'm that new thing that's in town. You feel me?
And Cameron wasn't talking like this in season one.
We about to find out some things.
We're gonna find out some things.
Cameron proved how much he loves her though. He as soon as he seen him caressing his girl's face, he jumps right to action.
I'm a fight for
immediately.
And you see what he did to Allen.
I'm a fight for.
Fight for.
I might kill for her
too.
Y'all
seen how Allen regained power with the gun in this? You know.
I was about to, so what?
Cameron's a dude that'd be like, I love you to death.
It mean that.
Literally.
Hey. Yeah. Hey, listen.
Yeah. Death to
no, on some real shit. Not like, on some Cameron to Lauren type of shit. Like, if I can't have you, nobody can.
Ooh.
That's how I like it.
Yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? Y'all take it for what it is, season two. You know, I do appreciate Alan popping out the cornball character with the baby Draco. He came out there with the revolver.
Yo, who gave him that piece?
He came, the revolver is a sure shot.
Yo,
you know, you're not going to jam.
The hand cannon is taking your face off.
You're not
going to
jam.
You only need six. You only need six.
Why? Oh, because it don't leave a shot. Oh,
yeah.
He's a smart.
Now that now that reload now.
Allen read that reload crazy, but that one that one right there goes nuts.
You already said what you hope for, right?
Well, I want to see what Allen going to do with that piece with in that his blip. Hand.
Yeah.
Yeah. What's about to happen? Is season two going to jump right where we left?
Picking up
right
if Allen stay true to brand, he ain't pulling nothing. Oh, God.
Allen going to pull it and miss.
Nah.
That's even worse. Wow.
Point blank.
Shooting blanks. Like
Allen shot it up, though.
He
ain't scared to pull the trigger.
Yeah.
But,
now he got to replace the hole in the wall.
But he's like a wannabe cop. Right. He's like a wannabe cop, right? So that would make sense. Yeah. Something like that.
He's got bad knees. He can't pass the physical.
He wanted to get a cop.
Bad knees. That's nuts.
Knees will get you out of there.
He's probably like the head of the neighbors watch committee.
Hell yeah.
Oh, my gosh. Hey, you got to stop killing Allen. Like,
she murdering you right now.
That is
your guy.
She been on everybody
that?
Now. She hit my hairstyle early. I feel like she came in like everybody's going to get it.
She's on a roll.
She got you. What? Yeah, she got me.
I didn't do anything, y'all.
You didn't say no 6'6 joke yet, man.
Nah, she been going off.
Before we get out of here.
Whatever.
All right, what's some, just the last couple of questions. What's some stuff that y'all hope to see for your character or other characters in season two? Like, what's some stuff that y'all hope to see or would like to see from your characters?
To touch on the other characters real quick, I want to shout out the characters that weren't able to be here tonight, including Kimberly Milan, who played my best friend. Mm-hmm. Shout out to her. Julius Mendez, who played his right-hand man. Unelli, who played Caroline. And then her mystery man. I forgot his
name.
Marvin. Yeah, man.
That was a perfect name for him, too. Marvin. Yeah. Oh, that was
Marvin. Yeah.
Marvin Gardens.
Yeah.
Yeah, we couldn't make it. We couldn't have this possible without their contribution to it. Yeah, for sure. Just wanted to shout them out real quick. But
shout out to y'all.
Yeah.
Who was y'all? They can't see.
Shout out to Ricky and McKenzie, man, making things possible.
Wait, no, I was talking about the audience, or to the other people.
I thought you were talking about these guys.
I would have pointed directly at them.
Hey, I was with you, brother.
Shout out to y'all too.
You just want to yell at people. That's what it is.
I wanted you to say their names, but you was talking about the.
Share the series, guys. Throw it on your Instagram. Throw it on your Facebook. Wherever you share cool stuff, make sure y'all sharing the series. Appreciate y'all.
But yeah, just say some of the stuff y'all hope to see for y'all characters.
I want to see my character at some point in time at a softer state. I want to see him more emotional, like, and not as much rage. It's sad sometimes because a lot of times people mask that all that rage and all that like deep down you really hurt inside and you're going through something. So I would like to see him on that side too. I feel like it's gonna be a challenge for me as an actor as well. So I'm looking forward to something like that.
It's just more character development. A little more background. Seems like he's enveloped in one situation. Like, what is his home life? What the hell does he do with his downtime? Is he just hunting, just shake down, just stalking and jumping?
Fix computers.
I want to see Allen get a girl.
Ooh, hey. That'd be nice.
That'd be interesting.
Get a little Asian.
He might be gay.
All right, bye. I'm out. Hey, appreciate y'all.
That's my cue. It was great doing
the first season with you guys. Shout out to everybody, this crew, the cast. You've been awesome.
Shout out to the community.
Allen's going to pop out with a little side thing.
Allen's going to be different in season two.
Pop up with an Edgar.
Oh, no, baby. That's
wild. With an Edgar.
Try me, man.
Ty.
I'm about to fight y'all.
Passenger Prince.
Not Passenger Prince.
Passenger Prince.
That's disgusting.
Y'all guys quit it. Y'all say I'm bad. Right.
What about y'all?
I just like to be in more than, 35 seconds this season.
We got you,
man.
We got you, Ty.
Hey, man.
Ty coming in hot, man.
Two minutes,
baby. Stand out for season two. Let's get it.
2 minutes at 6'6". Gonna be crazy. In 4K?
Ooh. More like 6'10".
I hope that Lauren wakes up from her faint of just freaking a shock of seeing her man, her ex-man.
Why was you in shock when I came through the door?
She knew
I wasn't
up.
Expecting you. You see, I was in lingerie. I was expecting someone else, baby.
I still got it.
But But yeah, I hope she wakes up, and I hope I hope
you
she gets
in lingerie.
In lingerie,
you did have a lingerie on.
I had it on. I had that shit on.
Oh, damn, but I gotta go back and watch the episode. Mm-hmm.
I hope she gets the clarity that she wants from these two men, because it seems like they're giving her a little bits and pieces of different things of their lives, and not the whole package, not the whole story. Give her the whole package, fellas. She can take the whole package. Trust her with it.
That's like she reaching for the pause.
No accountability.
Trust her with it. Package. Let her make a decision based off of that.
Off the packages.
The full entire. Don't leave anything out.
That is also disgusting.
You guys' minds are in the gutter.
Ooh.
That's a nice package, boys.
You know, you can't be looking me in my eyes when you say that.
Ricky looked at him and said, "That's a nice package."
Oh, hey, no, I didn't. I said it looking one way.
Nah, friend. He panned.
If you panned, that means you looked at
he
the whole squad.
Everybody.
No,
that's some nice package.
Straight. And then, hey, he was straight in my soul, bro.
Froze that buddy who was 6 foot
your
six.
It's crazy.
He locked eyes with me.
It was what that is?
Yeah, you know when you look at somewhere and another nigga like... Like, bro.
Hey, stop staring at me. Oh, how you know I'm looking at you? You ain't looking at me.
Right. Bad.
Yeah. The Drewski? That's what just happened.
Oh, Spider-Man
true,
meme.
True.
Yeah.
Shoot, maybe Lauren could get with Marvin. We'll see.
Nah. Lauren, do you have any morals?
How is that realistically
that's
gonna happen?
That's
his
crazy.
Ex. She's leaving no stones.
Lauren is about to be a pure savage season two as a
war. Lauren just wants somebody to treat her well and not leave her in her time of need.
That's another tall dude. He's 6'4". So it's like.
That's another tall, bald guy.
All the low bobs living through Lauren.
Shout out to all the bald guys, man.
We need some 5'9 women.
The bald guys that are shaven. The bald guys that are, you know, it's just fell out.
Oh,
there it is. You asked for it. It finally came. Pause.
What about that connection?
Hey, yo, her energy is a straight menace, right?
She's
now.
An Aquarius. That's what they do.
Guys, really see who's the true menace behind the scenes.
Real quick, say your zodiac signs, real quick, just so they can make inferences.
That's what we're gonna wrap the podcast up, guys.
Appreciate our social
Aquarius gang. That's it.
Appreciate that.
Social too.
All right.
I'm a Gemini.
I think we're good, Cancer.
Aries.
All
right. Are we doing it for real? Scorpio. Yeah. All
right. Oh, there it is.
Capricorn for real. And then Ken is Aries.
Appreciate y'all.
Aries gang out,
y'all. We love y'all.
We love y'all.
Hope y'all enjoy this season. You know what to do. Share.
And watch it again. If you watch it one time, it's not enough.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And stay tuned for more information.
Share it with your family members.
Or be a part of the series.
Start that sentence over.
And then stay tuned for more information on how to help and be a part of the series in any capacity, either financially or if you want to work on this on set, or if you're an actor. We're always looking for actors to fill smaller roles that have potential to grow. Mm-hmm. So, you know, just stay tuned.
Make sure you follow Buried Web Series on Instagram as well. We've got some behind the scene footage, pictures and videos on there for you guys to check out as well.
Yeah, it's lit.
All right. See you on the next one. Love y'all like a play cousin. We all out. Right.
Thanks for listening to the Real Talk Pill Talk podcast. See you soon.